So hello students, it is our lecture number 5, English language for class 9 and matric. This is Safran and today our learning agenda is conditional sentences. Okay, what are conditional sentences? Before teaching you conditional sentences, I bring your attention to our first lecture. In first lecture, I taught you sentences and its types. I taught you their sentences on the basis of function or meaning. But before learning conditional sentences, I teach you types of sentences on the basis of structure. I told you that on conditional sentences I will teach you this, because without learning on the basis of structure sentences, we cannot learn conditional sentences. Okay, so there are 4 types of sentences on the basis of structure. First is simple sentence, second is compound sentence, third is complex sentence, fourth is compound complex sentence. We can say complex compound sentence as well. And in these sentences, you learn clause, independent clause and dependent clause, because without learning these 3 terms, it is impossible to learn this all 4 sentences. What is clause? You know, what is sentence? Sentence is a complete thought, okay, which you get a complete sense, from which you get a complete sense, okay. But clause is what? In that you can find a verb as well as subject, but meaning is incomplete. Clause is what? A group of words in which you find subject as well as main verb, but meaning is incomplete. That is called clause. Okay, independent clause and dependent clause. Actually, independent clause comes with subordinating conjunction clause, and that clause is complete clause. That clause gives you complete meaning because it merges with subordinate conjunction clause. That's why it is called independent clause, but it has its own complete meaning. Okay, it has subject, it has main verb. So due to its combination with subordinating conjunction, that's why we call it independent clause, but its meaning is complete. Dependent clause is what? It has its subject, it has its main verb, but it is merged, it is linked with a subordinating clause, subordinating word. That's why it is incomplete. Okay students, now I start simple sentence. So simple sentence is what? A simple sentence consists of one independent clause. An independent clause contains a subject and a verb and expresses a complete thought. Okay? So 2 minutes ago I told you what are independent clause. It has its own subject and verb and have complete thought. Example, he writes a letter, she cleans the glass. Okay, complete thought about subject and verb. Okay, in the second sentence, compound sentence. In compound sentences, 2 or more independent clauses. Okay, not one, 2 or more independent clause joined by a conjunction. Okay, this is important. Combined by a conjunction, each of these clauses could form a sentence alone. Okay, example, I play cricket, one clause. My brother sings song, another clause. And these 2 clauses are joined with this AND word, that is what? Conjunction. Okay, so when we combine 2 independent clauses with conjunction, it becomes compound sentences. Now Now, complex sentences. I have mentioned some conjunctions and verb nor or yet. So, for independent clauses. Okay. Complex sentence is what? It consists of an independent clause and a dependent clause. Independent clause is what? Which has a main verb and a verb, main verb and a subject, and has complete meaning. It gives complete thought. But independent clause is what? It has a subject, it has main verb, but it does not infer complete meaning. Okay, that is what? Dependent clause. Dependent clause. So complex sentence is what? Complex sentence has an independent clause and a dependent clause. Now look at this example. The museum was very interesting, as I expected. Now look at this student. This part. Actually, this is what? Independent clause. Okay, the museum was very interesting. So was is what? As a main verb is used here of this subject, for this complement here, and as. Now look at this as. As is what? As is subordinating conjunction. So when we use dependent clause, we have to use what? Subordinating conjunction. As I mentioned here, after, as, because, before, if, when, while, are all subordinating conjunction. So independent clause contains a subordinating conjunction, and I expected, it is main verb, it is subject, but it is incompletion verb. So this is what complex sentence. In second sentence you find that when she was young, this is independent clause, and she believed in fairy tales. It's complete thought. Due to with the connection of this sentence, it becomes independent, and it is dependent clause, because it contains what? It contains subordinating conjunctions. Now third one, if it rains today, we will play cricket inside. So this is what? Independent clause, complete thought, and it is dependent clause, incomplete thought. Okay, because it has used what? If, and if as a subordinating conjunction. Now compound complex sentence. What are compound complex sentences? It consists of at least two independent clauses. Complex sentence contains one, and compound complex sentence contains two independent clauses and one or more dependent clauses. Okay, so now look at this example. When I grow up, so you can see when. When is what? Subordinating conjunction. So it becomes what? Dependent clause. It does not refer complete meaning. I want to be a pilot. So I want to be a pilot is what? Independent clause. It contains complete meaning, but with the link, just because of link to this one, it becomes independent clause. And. And is what? And is conjunction. My mom is proud of me. So it is also an independent clause. It contains complete meaning. It also contains a complete meaning. So this is independent clause. This is also independent clause. And this is what? Dependent clause. Okay students, now we start our actual topic today of conditional sentences. Okay. Without learning this concept of complex sentences and compound sentences, we cannot learn this conditional sentences.